First of all, I've got a messy kitchen, all right? I work like 80 hours a week and do college, so just think about that before you hit me too hard. So we're gonna have the recipe of the Edison battery electrolyte. You're gonna need 10 liters of distilled water. Okay. Then you're gonna need 1 pound, ounces, grams. You're gonna need 3,000 grams of potassium hydroxide. Okay. That's how you measure it. One of these scales you can get off of Amazon for very inexpensive, like $20 or less. No reason not to have a good scale. This is what it looks like. It's basically hard flakes. Okay. And see, there's a deoxygenator packet in there. A few got by. And they're floating around in there. I'm hoping they're not going to do anything because I can't fish them out at this point in time. Reason being, you don't want to use anything metal when you make this, right? You want to use glassware, possibly plastic, but I suggest glass. I got this Pyrex 19-liter carboy with surplus from chemical supply house. Got that off of eBay. Also got this big old swizzle stick. It's a Pyrex stir stick. Use that. And I'm sure you can get away with not using these, but using the right tools makes all the difference for ease of use. Okay, so, and then let me show you. I use this pitcher. I got this from Walmart. It's just for lemonade or something. But you turn on this unit, and that's a brown right there if you want to know what it is. Waymax. It'll tear it for you. Tear means it'll account for the weight of the container. And so you just dump in your 3,000 grams, which would be a 3 right here for kilograms. Right? Because a kilo is 1,000, so 3 right here would be 3,000 grams. And then you put that in, and there's some extra here. It heats up, and the way you account for that is you want to stick this big old jar in your kitchen sink and fill your sink with water. That way, when this liquid heats up, it doesn't get too hot because you have cool water in your sink here. And then the jar container floating in it. I've heard some people doing it with ice water. I just use the sink. It worked great. They use ice on the exterior. I use cold water. Of course, it is really cold. It's in November. This stuff, you put a little bit of that. Put a little bit of that potassium hydroxide in at a time, and you got to mix just a little bit at a time because it's reactive, and you stir it. And you always want to add potassium hydroxide to water. Never, never, never add water to potassium hydroxide. Supposedly it'll explode or something, so don't do it. No, I did not test it. Okay? Because I can listen to advice. Okay, next for the recipe, you're going to want. See, I just that's how much that thing weighed in grams. Next for the recipe, you're gonna want 200 grams of lithium hydroxide monohydrate. So this is 100 grams here. Kind of looks like a, it's a, well, you know what it looks like, right? You seen movies? All right, so you need 200 grams of that lithium. 3,000 grams of potassium hydroxide, and then of course 10 liters of distilled water. Okay, that'll make you a good batch, and it's very easy, especially with these measurements and stuff. I originally thought I'd have to use one of these, which is a smaller scale, gram scale. It came in handy when those two mistakes happened in there. I took out a dry one, weighed it, multiplied it by two, and then added the equivalency of KOH. So, anyway, scales are great. So, where am I at this point? Let's take you down. This is Veterans Day, November 2017. Finally had a little time to do stuff for me instead of for other people. Always doing stuff for other people. So, here we got A4H Edison batteries. There's 10 of them. Supposedly they're charging. Now, a little comment. I did not use lithium for this recipe. It's optional. Lithium adds about 10% gain. Unfortunately, lithium is very, very expensive. Really expensive. Go look at how expensive it is. I got some from Industrial Surplus. Didn't pay that much, but still. What a nerd friend of mine, an old hillbilly dude, and a guy off in the Caribbean, who won't be named, said is don't use the lithium for the initial batch because this is a test run and lithium's too expensive to waste. So that's what's going on here. The original 850X Edison manual said 4.5 pounds of solution per A4H cell, so that's what's in there. Pounds of electrolyte, alkaline electrolyte. So the Edison manual also said 7 hours at 30 amps. Well, this is a test run. I'm not going to be doing that. Plus, my options are a little limited right now for various reasons. But what we do have is 2 amps going in. Here, 2 amps, and I'll get another view of that. I'm blocking my, so it's at 2 amps, and I put it for a few minutes to test it, and then now I have it at 30 minutes, so very slow charge. Very first time I've done this, should we look in there and see what's going on? Are they bubbling? I don't really want to look because that stuff, oh, that's the other thing. Have some vinegar ready because that's like the antidote if you get it in your face or whatever. Vinegar. I'm a little reluctant to look in there, but let's do it for science, right? I don't know how long this video will be. Okay. And then all the cells have serials and stuff. I need to actually get that and keep records. Don't see anything going on there. So nothing bubbling yet. It is 2 amps when it requires 30 amps by the manual. The manual also said you could do it for less than 30 amps, but it'll take longer, a lot longer. So I'm just doing 2 amps real safely. This is a Schumacher battery charger. It's got different settings. 40 amps, 10 amps, 2 amps. it's got a 6-volt setting and whatever. If you need, if you have an old vehicle, it's 6 volts. But it's doing okay. I got it, I think, off of Amazon. It had a tote rack to it. It kind of wasn't that stable, and so now I can't wheel it around as easily. I haven't used it very much, but if it's putting out 2 amps, it's enough for testing purposes. So I just wanted to make this little video to show what I can do when I have some free time ready. And I'll show these labels here. I'm sure you can find them in some of my other videos, but I asked pretty hard to get these labels when they're down in there. Yeah, go look on my other video. Basically, there's 2 different labels. You can get a little bit of a view on that one. That's a newer one. The other one was older. But I'm gonna. There's a channel on YouTube called Hillbilly Homestead. He's the guy in there. Really smart. Really good with stuff like this. And he's the one that got me interested in these Edison batteries. So go check out his channel. And. Plus other people too. There's Rhandsom. He's got nickel cadmium batteries and nickel iron batteries. That's another channel to check out. It's Are You Rhandsom? Rhandsom. Well, anyway, if you're interested in batteries, you're gonna run across this channel. It's doing good. Then there's Mr. X, which he suggested don't use anything but nickel bus bars, and it's a little out of budget right now, so I'm gonna use these for now. These are the original bus bars were nickel plated copper, and then this is, of course, strand copper. I think it's a hot gauge, zero gauge. Bought those off the eBay, the custom, sure as I can get them. I think 6 inches and such. And I'm missing the caps here for, obviously these are nice caps. There's different designs of these caps, but I missed them for this. So what I did is I took a US quarter, wrapped it in rubber, put it in a rubber glove, like the finger part, right? Wrapped it in there, broke it off, and then threw it in there. And so hopefully that'll provide somewhat of a seal. Still up in the air. There's something called Chevron 22 oil, and then there's mineral oil. This still up in the air. Well, I want to put oil in these. Hillbilly Homestead said don't do it. Or he doesn't do it. He didn't say not to do it, but he says he doesn't do it. Mr. X said don't do it unless you have Chevron 22. And so, I think Rhandsom was experimenting with it, but, so yeah, I mean, it's going to be hard to get that out of there once I put it in. So initially, since this is just a test batch with just the, not lithium in there, just the regular potassium hydroxide, I think I should just let him go. That's the other thing, my nerd buddy, he said he had an A4H cell too, just one, but he charged it, discharged a few times, and then changed out the electrolyte after that, because I guess the process of charging, discharging can help clean inside, maybe. So that's, I think that's the angle I'm going to go for. Just kind of go really easy, real slow here, because these are very hard to find, very expensive, and I don't want to mess it up. So just a little 2 amp charge right now on the most inexpensive. Potassium hydroxide is not expensive. It's about the same price as laundry soap, a good laundry soap or whatever, which is basically one of the components of laundry soap. But so I don't mind using some of that to test run, and I have a little extra to do some other things. That thing behind there is a military chest freezer slash refrigerator. You can only do one or the other. I got it pretty inexpensive, but the display does not work. But it runs off at 12 volt or 24 volts, so that's another project. So I think this is it for this video. As far as getting that big old Edison encyclopedia, I'm still, look, I am totally rammed down the throat with crazy obligations. I'm telling, I only have a few.